What is up, you hooligans? Welcome back to another video. As always, I appreciate you guys coming back and checking out yet some more content, another dope video dropping. So without further ado, if you're looking for some extra reliability on your bolts, on the main compartments of your motor, because it's not unheard of, especially when you're servicing certain parts of your motor, you're going to have bolts that strip out, the head strip. Sometimes they break off inside of the motor or wherever it is the bolt is at. And to combat that issue is to use high quality machined ARP bolts. And ARP bolts are a fantastic alternative to getting the factory crappy OEM bolts out and swapping it out with some awesome ARP bolts. Now, with that said, there is a company called Hail Speed that makes fantastic kilo kits. They call them kilo kits, and it's going to be the kits come in different packages. You have like your primary an engine package, you got like your transmission side package, and then they even are starting to do ones for your hand controls. They also make awesome 12-point dipstick caps for your engine oil, and then full machined dipsticks for your transmission. And I'm going to show you what those look like here in just a second. Now, today, what we're doing is we're going to be doing the left side of the bike, so the primary side of the bike, and then which also includes our Trask vented transmission top cover. Now, with Hail Speed, he offers multiple options. You can do stainless, which is what I did, or you can do a black Cerakoted version of the bolts. And it also comes with your choice of colored washers. And these washers add that nice little pop of color to that black motor, which really stands out. Now, when you're placing an order with Hail Speed, I will say these are handmade in-house by one or two people. Guys, these aren't something that's mass-produced. You can place the order and it ships out same day and you get it 2 days later. It's not the way this works. So if you're expecting, if you have no patience whatsoever and you're used to the Amazon lifestyle of ordering in the morning and getting your order that same day, you're gonna be disappointed. Perfection takes time. Now, the dude that makes these is a perfectionist. He is a perfectionist. You're not gonna get a bolt that has a blemish or an imperfection. The dude is a perfectionist and it takes time to make something that is perfectly made and not flawed and something that's dependable. So when you place your order, just place your order, forget about it for a couple weeks. You'll be glad you did because you're gonna get a top of the line product. These bolts are amazing quality and I was just blown away by how well these are made. So without further ado, let's take a dive down and get a deeper look and a closer up of how these look. All right, so check this out. The packaging on this is phenomenal as well. And shout out for the dope slaps. Appreciate that. Some slaps always come in handy. Thank you for those. So here is our 12-point dipstick for our transmission. Show you that in a second when we take it out to put it in. We got our top cap for our oil side. Again, these are machined, guys. These are very, very good quality. Let me pull this one out. And everything's nice and labeled. So there's no guesswork. Obviously, this is just a cap, but with the bolts, no guesswork on what bolt goes where. So as you can see, these are nice machined caps. That's gonna look dope. Now, when I placed my order, I totally forgot to add this cap to match the transmission dipstick. And this dude is such a perfectionist that he legit was like, we can't have your kit looking incomplete because it doesn't complete the look. So I'm tossing that in for you. Shout out to him. He didn't do that because I'm doing a review on this. He did it because he wanted his kit to look the absolute best that it could look. So thank you for doing that. Appreciate that. You didn't have to do that. For anybody thinking you're going to get a free cap, don't even think about it. It's probably not going to happen. Don't ask. Honestly, like, please don't ask for discounts or free shipping or anything. Like, this is a small business that is trying to survive up against the big companies. So if you want to support small businesses, guys, please do. It goes a long way, but asking for discounts and stuff like that, it takes away, honestly, from them making money. All right, so here I ended up going with the red washers because obviously the bike is this hard candy red. Our trans top cover nuts. Set those aside. We got our primary cover washers. I don't know why I said nuts on the other ones, but they're washers. We got our trans trapdoor washers. Put those aside to match those up with the bolts. And we got our trans side cover washers as well. And we'll put those off to the side. Now, look how great these things look. 12 point ARP bolts. So we got our trans top cover hardware there. Machined out of, or 6061 aluminum. Very, very, very good quality. As you can see, each one is stamped ARP. You got our 12 points on there. And like I said, these are hand machined in shop. Amazing quality. And then we got our trans trapdoor bolts. And then we got our four big guys for our primary case. Trans side cover bolts. Match those up with the washers. And then primary cover, one of two. We'll match those up with those washers. So that's it for this side. And like I said, they do offer the package for the other side, for the right side. The way I'm going to do this is I am going to, instead of removing every single one at once, I'm going to go through and remove one at a time and then replace it with the new bolts and washers and just make my way around. That way we're not losing fluid out of here and we're not having to replace our gasket because it peeled away from the case. Get ready for fast mode because I'm about to put you on fast forward, son. Let's do it. So 3/16 on these guys. So we're going to take one of our washers, one of our bolts, just like that. Get that guy in there. Snug it down. Grab our ratchet for it. And then we're going to take our 5/16 socket. Boom. Just like that. One down. 12 more to go. Looks really good. Look at that. Would you look at it? Boom, boom, boom. These really are like unbelievable quality. How well these are made. And before anybody says, oh, you're just giving them a good review because you sent you that stuff. Nope. I paid for this stuff. I paid out of pocket for this stuff. Not like it would have mattered on the review. If it would have sucked and it was sent to me for free, I would have been like, you know, I can't really get behind these on the price. They're good, but they're not like crazy good. Or now that I'm relieved, they're incredible quality. I can say without a shadow of a doubt, these are absolutely 100% very well made, meticulously handcrafted by somebody with insane OCD, and it shows in the product. Like, it really does. It shows in the craftsmanship of how well these are made. Look how, I mean, for how small those heads are, look how defined those cuts are on those heads. And these are all coming out of a solid block of billet aluminum. All right, I'm gonna finish up the primary. Once we get done switching out the primaries, I'll meet you right back here. I'm gonna jam out to some music while I finish up the rest, and then we'll move on to the dreaded death zone where my hands don't want to work because it's such a tight area. I don't like that area. It's a pain in the ass. These little bolts are, don't like it. Not looking forward to it, but they're going to look really good on that chrome. All right, I'll meet you guys back here in a sec. All right, so about 10 minutes later, we got them all swapped out. It's the minor things that make these bikes really pop. And just adding some little cosmetic beauty rings, washers to some nice stainless ARP bolts will really liven up that primary case. It looks really good. All right, I'm gonna give you guys a big secret tip. If you've ever messed with your transmission cover, the top cover for your transmission right here, you know that putting a damn Allen key to get these six bolts out is a huge pain. like literally painstakingly terrible, especially the bolts that are right up against your fins. The best thing you can do, do yourself a favor and buy a low clearance ratchet that'll fit in there and get you the space, very limited space in there, and this will help to get those out and to put the new ones in. I wish I had this when I put this top trans, the Trask cover in. This helps a lot with oil blow by and venting excessive pressure in your crankcase. So if your bike's spitting up a lot of oil, this will help alleviate that issue with that excessive pressure in your crankcase. I promise. Get yourself one of these little ratchets, these low clearance ratchets. You can get them on Amazon. You don't have to go all out and get the damn Snap-on version. You can get one that comes in a little kit like this, has a bunch of different heads, different sizes, different shapes. Awesome little tool, especially when you have very low clearance spaces like this. So it's hard to see in there on this side, but we got our hardware on our trans cover, as you can see there. So now we're just gonna do our transmission dipstick. Pretty straightforward. This one just replaces factory one. So just lift that out, set it aside. Take our new one here. Boom. Hail speed. And we'll just drop this guy in. Boom. Just thread it in. Yeah, just 9/16. Doesn't need to be cranked down super tight. Just get it snug. All right, snugged. All right, and then the oil, this one's a little bit different. We're gonna have to just pop off the OEM dipstick. It's pretty straightforward. If we just take a flathead screwdriver to it, like maybe I might have busted one of these off. Yeah, one of them busted off. But, oh well, it's not the end of the world, hopefully. And this should just pop in there. There we go. I just push down, get that. Nice. Tight on there, all the way around. Just like that. Now we got a matchy-matchy oil and transmission. But so far, it's definitely, I mean, it adds a nice little element aesthetically. And like I said, it reinforces. ARP bolts are definitely stronger than these chintzy guys that Harley uses. You can definitely tell the difference in thread quality. Here's the ARP. But you can tell the thread quality and just how they're machined. There's a night and day difference in machining quality of these versus stock. If you put them side by side. It's just, they're just sharper and more, I don't know the word for it, but they're just more precise cut, I guess, with a sharper edge. Not a single bolt that I've replaced so far, the ARPs, not a single one has snagged or got hung up or tried to cross thread or anything. Not a single issue, even with these ones down here, that were hard to reach and weird angles got snagged up or issue threading it in, they all went in buttery smooth. So, but yeah, next up, trans side cover and then the trap door, and then we'll be done. So it is the next day. We're going to be moving on to the transmission side of things. I'm going to start by getting most of the bolts that we can access. I really hope I can do this without loosening my exhaust. That is literally the last thing I want to do. So just to loosen these, I'm going to use the impact. It's a 1/4-inch hex head bit. So I'm just going to start slow to get these out. And anytime you remove something that's been in there for a while, I always just keep a rag handy just to wipe off the mating surfaces to make sure there's a nice clean contact when we put the new piece of hardware in, or a gasket, or whatever it is that you're doing. I'm gonna go ahead and get going on this side, get these top two off, and then we'll get the replacement bolts. Go slow at first, make sure you're not cross-threading. None of these have cross-threaded so far or grabbed weird or anything like that, so I'm not really worried about it. Boom. And don't get it mixed up. With a couple of these bolts on this side, you do have two that are different that have the smoothed out flange right underneath the flange. It's smoothed out compared to the others that have threading right up to the head. There is two in there. It's self-explanatory. You're just matching bolt for bolt. Take one out, put the corresponding right one in. Not hard to do. All right, guys, so that does it for the transmission side. We were left with like 6 bolts left because with this aftermarket clear case from Nice CNC, can't utilize the factory, the inner bolts that usually go right here. I'll show you a picture of how it should look if you have the factory setup still on your bike. That's how it should look. But with this one, couldn't utilize them, so we just did what we could do with the OEMs that are still there and exposed to be used. But that left us with like 4 or 6, I think 6 bolts and washers left over. I was able to use a couple just on the sides here. You can see them there. But overall, man, these things are kick-ass. They're a great little package of really good quality bolts and washers. And I'm liking the way that red pops against the gold. I mean, that's how the whole bike is, the whole theme of the bike. So it's red and gold. And then we got our transmission dipstick here. The 12-point and then the 12-point oil dipstick cap. Boom! So that's going to do it for the install on all these. Here in a little bit, when I can afford it, he does offer a cam chest kit. Covers all these bolts and then our tappet cuff bolts and all that. And so we'll be swapping those out as soon as I can afford to do so. That way everything's matched up. We got our whole motor and everything done up. But I think it turned out really, really good. Like I said, the quality's just been fantastic. But that's why, like I was saying earlier, that When you place an order on these guys, these are handmade. Like, they're legitimately handmade in a shop by one or two people. Like, it's not a factory of people just turning these out around the clock. It's hardworking dudes in California turning these out by hand, taking a single block of billet aluminum, I believe it's 6061 billet aluminum, and turning each bolt by hand. So they did a fantastic job. It shows in the product, and I couldn't be happier with the way it turned out. They did a really, really good job on these, so shout out to him. I'll definitely be placing an order for the hand controls for sure, for our perch clamps and everything, and then for the rest of the motor, get that all squared away and matched up. So, but yeah, he really did do a fantastic job with these Kilo kits, guys. If you're interested, I'll drop a link to his website in the description. It's just hellspeed.com. Like I said, they're not inexpensive, they're not cheap kits, but the quality is definitely there. You're not gonna have to worry about any issues with these bulk kits. I mean, support American made when you can. Obviously, that's not always possible, but in this situation, this instance, it is possible. And the dude's a stellar guy, man. Like, the whole company's just solid. So I can't give enough praise. Solid people running a solid company, putting out solid products. And it's, from start to finish, it's just solid. That's really the best word I can think of, because that's just the way it is. They're solid. And I'm stoked to be running their products on my bike. It really adds a nice little flair, little subtle flair to it. And it's not like, boom, in your face, holy shit, look at this change. But when you look at it, you definitely notice that meticulous craftsmanship throughout the bike when you see these bolts and washers on there, because it does add a nice finishing touch. You know what I mean? It's not just crummy, rusty looking bolts churned out from a factory by the millions. These are handmade one by one. So when you place your order, give the dude a break, a week or two, you know what I mean, to get it out to you. You're gonna be happy that you waited and you were patient. And I promise you that if you order a kit, you're gonna be back for a second kit, for something else, or for a different bike, because these are fantastic. And like I said, I paid out of pocket. I paid full price for these. There was no hookups, anything like that. They did a fantastic job. And I'm definitely gonna be getting this side done. Or the other, I should say the rest of this side done, because part of this side's done with the transmission side, but definitely gonna be placing an order and getting some more matchy-matchy going on. Anyway, much love, you guys. As always, broadcasting from Utah, out to y'all, to the world. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace out. Bye.